How do you learn to become a writer?
I think the best writers are voracious readers who pick up the cadences and the feel of narration through a number of different books, and you begin by maybe copying the style of writers that really knocked you out. Mm-hmm. I mean, as a teenager, I read a lot of H.P. Lovecraft, so I wrote like H.P. Lovecraft. Yeah. And when in my 20s, I read a lot of Ross McDonald and Raymond Chandler, so I wrote like those guys. But little by little, you develop your own style.
Do you want to become a writer, or do you want to write a book? Today, we'll talk about 10 writing tips for beginners from the book On Writing by Stephen King. These tips were very helpful while I was writing my own book, Turn Your Happiness On. So if you want to find more strategies to lead a happy, healthy, and fulfilling life, you will find them in this book. If you're new here, my name is Norma Nikutowski. I'm a psychologist and happiness coach, and in this channel, you will find tips and strategies for a healthy, happy, and fulfilling life. 10 writing tips for beginners from the book On Writing by Stephen King. Do you need a writing routine?
Yeah, there's a kind of self-hypnosis involved with it too. If you start at the same time every day, most writers have little routines they go through. I like to always stop with a couple of pages that are just raw copy, where I haven't touched it, I haven't tried to revise it, I haven't tried to polish it. It's like having a little bit of a runway. The next day when you sit down, you have the comfort of saying, well, I've got a little bit here, used to be in the typewriter, now it's in the magic box.
Create a writing routine. Make sure that you write every day a certain number of pages or a certain number of words. Look for a boring, dull corner to write. In addition, your writing space needs a door that you need to keep shut. The closed door tells yourself and others that you're serious about writing. This will help you to focus on your story. Also, eliminate all possible distractions. Keep your phone away, close the curtains so that your mind can easily turn inward. When you write, you want to get rid of the whole world around you and create your own world. Over time, you will be able to filter out the distractions, but in the beginning, it's best to keep the distractions away. The longer you repeat this writing routine, the easier it will become. Having a consistent routine helps the muse to find you. If he knows where you are, where you are working, he will show up and share his magic. Listen to music if it helps you to concentrate. Stephen King likes listening to music, to hard rock music such as Metallica or AC/DC while he writes. Stephen King's writing routine.
The way that I work, I try to get out there and I try to get 6 pages a day. So with a book like End of Watch, and I work, when I'm working, I work every day, 3-4 hours, and I try to get those 6 pages and I try to get them fairly clean. So if the manuscript is, let's say, 360 pages long, that's basically 2 months' work. It's concentrated, but it's a fairly, but that's assuming that it goes well.
And you do hit 6 pages a day?
I usually do.
You don't ever have a day where you sit down there and it's like constipation and you write a sentence and you hate the sentence and
okay.
you check your email and you wonder if you had any talent after all and maybe you should have been a plumber. Don't you have days like that?
No, I mean, there's real life. You know, I can be working away and something comes up and you have to basically get up and you have to go to see the doctor or you have to take somebody a care package or you have to go to the post office because whatever. But mostly I try to get the 6 pages in.
Read as much as you can. Stephen King reads between 70 and 80 books per year, mostly fiction, just because he enjoys reading. There are lessons to be learned from every book. For example, reading books that you dislike helps you to become a better writer because you learn what not to do. There is nothing more inspiring for an aspiring writer than thinking that your work is better than that of someone who actually got paid for his or her work. Also, think about the last book that you read and thought, I can do better than this, because you have a good idea of what not to do. You will be able to include more of what you like in your own work while avoiding what you dislike in other people's stories. Also, reading helps you to experience different styles and see how your writing compares to that of others. Do you plan out your stories?
I very rarely. Sometimes I have an idea of how the book will finish up, but it very rarely finishes up the way that I think it's gonna. You have to go where the book leads you. I go where the story leads, and sometimes it is a little bit outrageous, and I relish that. I sort of want to be as much on the edge as I can, and I want to engage the reader. I'm an emotional writer.
Choose a situation. To start, put one or more characters in a difficult situation and see how they find their way out. The situation comes first. Stories make themselves. There is no need to have a plot in advance. You only need to follow the story. Stories are like found fossils in the ground. The writer has to use the tools in his toolbox to get him out of the ground without breaking them. Stories are like relics, part of an undiscovered pre-existing world. Even if you have an idea of the outcome, most times the characters will do something different. Write about anything you want as long as you tell the truth. Write the genre that you love to read the most. Write what you like, then imbue it with life and make it unique by blending in your own personal knowledge of life, friendship, relationship, sex, and work. People love reading about work. How do you handle rejections?
I started to send stories out, and I pounded a nail into the wall of my bedroom. And when I got the rejection slips back, I would put them on that nail. And by the time that I was 16 or 17 years old, the nail tore free from the plaster. So I just got a bigger nail. And
always have a book available. Take a book with you everywhere you go. This could be a physical book, an ebook, an audiobook. You can easily have an ebook and audiobook on your phone. There are so many times when we have to wait, and having a book to read makes the waiting time more enjoyable. Read at every opportunity you have. Listen to audiobooks in your car, while exercising, or while doing busy work. If you want to be a writer, you need to turn inward toward your imagination. Reading will allow your mindset to easily transition from reality to imagination, where you can easily write. You also get an idea of what has been done and what is fresh. The more you read, the more you will identify in others and your own writing what works. Read a lot, write a lot is the great commandment if you want to be a writer. Where do stories come from?
I don't think that you find them exactly. I think that what you do is you keep your sensors open. And it's the more that you do the job, the more you come to understand in a kind of intuitive way that you're always, you know, your radar is on and the thing is going around and around and around and it's not picking up any blips. And then something will happen and it will click and you'll say, this is an idea for a story. And for me, I'm usually working on something, so that's kind of got to go to the end of the line. And the best thing about that is that the bad ideas kind of just drop out of the mix. You forget about them, the good ones stick around, so.
Write and rewrite. You are telling a story to yourself when you write the first draft of a story. Then when you rewrite, you need to take out all the things that do not belong to the story. The first draft is just for the writer. Once you have an idea of what the story will be about, it's time to rewrite and share it with the world. Stories consist of three parts. The narration that moves the story from point A to point B. Description, which includes sensory details for the reader to immerse into the story. And dialogue that will bring characters to life. Description starts in the writer's mind, but should end in the reader's imagination. Clearly see in your mind what you want to describe on the piece of paper. Clear writing begins with fresh images and simple vocabulary. Fiction usually begins with a story and develops into a theme, and not the other way around. Once King got the rejection letter that changed his rewriting process, here is the rewrite formula. Second draft equals first draft minus 10%. He copied this formula on a cardboard and taped it next to his typewriter. When talking about pacing, keep the story moving forward and take out the boring parts. This means to speed the pace to keep the reader glued to the page. However, if you go too fast, you may leave the reader behind and lost. So let each story unfold at its own pace. What is creativity?
I think creativity is a mystery. We talked about this a little bit. And I think that you have a package inside you that at some point it's like live material and it starts to stir. You know, you get close to something.
Get started. The best time to get started is right now. Don't wait to start writing when you have more time, when your kids are in college, or once you get a better paying job. Find a quiet place. With the door, create a routine and start writing. Stephen King is the author of more than 60 books, all of them worldwide bestsellers. If you like this video, remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.